New at 5:30, it's been years since any new books have been put on the shelves at the Benton Harbor High School Library. That's because it's been closed for 2 years. WSBT's Denise Bone reports a group of graduates got it up and running again.
Money struggles kept the library in Benton Harbor High School closed for many years. In fact, this heavy chain was put across the door. But thanks to a retired librarian and some friends, the library has been reopened.
These are the ones we got.
Eden Goldstein graduated from Benton Harbor High School.
I don't remember what year. They didn't have calendars then.
When she and fellow alum Tiffany Butzbaugh, who's also a retired librarian, discovered their former school library was shut down, they went to work.
We've just rolled up our sleeves. We've been cleaning. We've been weeding out the old books.
For a month, they scrubbed the tables and walls and sorted, and then cleaned and organized some more, moving hundreds of books around.
We thought, I don't know if we can do this.
But they did, and without any money. They started by opening up just one day a week, but word spread. Volunteers came forward.
They all have just knocked on my door. My phone is ringing, my email's going. What can I do?
The shelves are now filled with donated books. They also have tutoring available and are starting a book club. Students like junior Mark McAfee, who's become a fan of science books, are thankful.
I'm just excited and glad that it's been open now.
This library helped me to succeed, and I think it's the least I can do to return the favor.
You put a lot of hours and hard work into this. Do you have a fear that it will close down again and be locked up?
Over my dead body. My cold, dead body.
Volunteers work at the library from Tuesday through Thursday, but it's always open during school hours for students to use. But the district is in need of more help because 4 out of the 5 elementary school libraries are closed with no money to pay staff to run them. Reporting from Benton Harbor, Denise Bone, WSBT, Channel 22 News.
And American Electric Power recently awarded those ladies a $500 grant to buy some new books for that library.
Indiana.